Hey everybody, John Nelson here to talk to you about Haas Indexable Milling Cutters and Inserts and HaasTooling.com. We recently redesigned some of our mill tooling web pages, and I want to familiarize you with those changes as well as some of the new cutters and inserts we have available. This is the current homepage of HaasTooling.com. When I click on Milling, notice that there's now a category for Indexable End Mill Bodies. We'll come back to that in a minute, but we're going to start here with shell mill bodies. Open this page and you'll see photos of the 8 currently available shell mill styles and a description of each, including the type of tool path, cutting edge angle, and maximum depth of cut. Following that are some bullet points about the cutter, and then we list the types of material the cutter is designed to cut and available insert grades. Just below that, don't forget to click the plus sign next to Cutter Series Videos to check out the different cutter styles in action. When we scroll down to the complete list of cutters, we see the filter categories on the left-hand side to help you narrow your search. The first filter category is Milling Cutter Series, and that has those 8 styles listed. If you know which one you want, click the filter box and it'll show all the diameters we have in that style. You can see the other filter categories listed, including cutting diameter, number of cutting teeth, cutting angle, etc. I want the 45 degree face mill with square inserts, so HSNP is what I'm looking for. So I'm going to the filter to see the available diameters. 3-inch is the right cutting diameter for me, so I click it and we'll see a gallery of images of that cutter, a drawing, and the technical specs. Right in the middle of the page is a link to the speed and feed chart. This chart is going to give you the speed and feed information you need. We recently reworked the charts for mill cutters to give more material detail. Use the values for surface footage and feed per tooth, and if your setup is solid, these numbers will work. These are the numbers we used when testing all of these cutters. Once you're cutting, you can tweak the speed and feed up or down based on your application. When we go back to the cutter page and scroll down, we see the related products. Here are a list of all of the inserts available for this cutter, as well as the tool holders that can be used. Now let's go back to the milling page. You see, we were here on shell mill bodies. Well, now we have an indexable end mill category. These are smaller diameter insert cutters with straight shanks that can go in a milling chuck, shrink fit holder, or even a Weldon style tool holders. They range from 1 to 1.5 inch cutting diameter. The HPAL are exclusively for aluminum, while the HIEX model takes inserts for steel, stainless steel, and cast iron. Now, back to milling, and this time I'm going to select milling inserts. The first thing on this page is a description of each of the grades we have for milling inserts. The important thing here is the application information of primary and secondary workpiece materials shown in that order. Also, be aware that not all grades are available in all insert styles. Scrolling down, we see the list of inserts and filter categories on the left-hand side. The first filter is Milling Cutter Series. Here's where you're going to see all the inserts available for a particular cutter. There's also a filter for insert grade and then primary workpiece material. This is where you're going to find out which cutters have inserts available for particular materials. My cutter was the 3-inch HSNP, so I clicked that filter. The job I'm preparing for is cast iron, so I'm going to click cast iron in the primary workpiece material category, and there's my insert. Now, if I click clear all filters and select, for example, aluminum as the primary workpiece material, my HSNP cutter is not available because that cutter is not designed for aluminum. Once you've chosen your cutter and insert, make sure to cross-reference them to verify they go together. If I click on this insert for aluminum, it shows me the milling cutter series here in the technical specifications, and this is not my cutter. I can also check the related products section below. Okay, I'm going to click Clear All Filters again, and this time I'm going to select aluminum as the primary workpiece material. We see there are four inserts available to cut this material. I chose this because I wanted to reinforce that not all shell mill bodies are made to cut aluminum, therefore only certain cutters have an available insert. And this also gives me the opportunity to mention that our new HPAL high performance cutters and inserts are specifically designed to cut aluminum. When you click on any insert, you'll see a description and a gallery of photos. Notice there's a speed and feed link here too. Okay, now back to our insert. Again, at the bottom, we have a list of products related to this insert. In this case, we see all the cutters that'll take this style of insert. The last thing I want to mention is the product review link at the bottom of every page on HaasTooling.com. We'd really like to hear your feedback about our tooling. We really appreciate you taking the time to provide honest and useful reviews of our products. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time.